Hello, Wentz. This is Joe aboard the International Space Station. I have you loud and clear.
Okay, thank you very much, Joe, for being in this downlink. We are going to start with the question immediately. We have a sequence of students are going to be there asking you questions. The first question is...
Hi, Joe. My name is Nelson Badillo Perez, and I study in the Inter-American School of Aguadilla. And I want to ask you, how do you compare your most recent spacewalk with previous spacewalks during your previous missions? And do you feel more comfortable or anxious?
Sí, yo me sentí más cómodo because this was my third one. Pero cada caminata tiene sus retos, entonces siempre hay que mantenerse enfocado, porque si no puede tener problemas, pero me sentí bien cómodo. Gracias. Y bienvenidos a la Estación Espacial Internacional.
Second question.
Did being a teacher provide any advantage to being an astronaut?
I think being a teacher is a great profession for becoming an astronaut. You have to be a good communicator. You have to think on your feet because the plans are always changing. So I think it's a great profession. Y quiero decir que yo creo que ser maestro es la profesión más difícil y más importante del mundo. Y quiero dar las gracias a todos los maestros por sus sacrificios y el trabajo que ustedes hacen diario. Muchísimas gracias.
I wanted to ask if you know the full schedule of the activities every day before you go to the ISS.
No, that's one of the fun things about being up here for a long period of time is you never know what you might see when you arrive, and you never know what might break. For example, our toilet broke just the other day, so we had to fix it, and of course, that was unexpected.
Hi, my name is Leslie Vargas. Could you describe a typical day in the and activities in the ISS?
Sí, pues un día típico aquí, levantamos como a las 6 de la mañana, empezamos a trabajar como a las 7:30, pero durante el día es algo diferente. Por ejemplo, estoy ahora aquí hablando con ustedes, y ahorita voy a trabajar con el vehículo de carga Dragon. And so every day is different. Usually we have the final conference at around 7:30 at night, and then we try to go to sleep maybe around 10 p.m. And somewhere in between there, we have lunch, breakfast, dinner, and we also exercise for about 2.5 hours every day.
Hi, my name is Nicole. I am representing Hogar Colegio La Milagrosa from Arecibo, and this is my question. What is the most impressive view from the ISS, and has your opinion changed during your trips?
Pero claro, tiene que ser la isla, y me gusta sacar, tomar fotos de ella, pero también me gusta ver los colores de África. The auroras are incredible. My opinion hasn't really changed, but every time that I'm here, it makes me realize more and more how much we need to protect our planet.
Do the astronauts have free time to socialize with the other crew members?
Sí, tratamos de cenar junto cada viernes. So we try to eat together every Friday night. Y los sábados juntamos otra vez para ver películas. So we'll try to get together on Saturdays. And of course, anytime that we have a holiday, just like we had Christmas and the New Year's. We always get together to celebrate that as one international crew.
Hi, I'm Misha Rivera from Colegio San Benito, and I wanted to ask, how did Puerto Rico look after Huracan Maria went through the island?
Pues lo primero que yo noté fue la falta de electricidad. So the first thing I noticed is that the lack of electricity in Puerto Rico. Usually when you fly over Puerto Rico at night, it's very easy to identify the island, and it was almost impossible to see it at night because of the lack of electricity. Y quiero decir que mi corazón y mis oraciones van a toda la gente de Puerto Rico. Yo sé que el tiempo fue difícil, todavía es difícil, y estoy pensando en ustedes.
Hi, my name is Carlos Jornet. I'm representing Miguel Such. And my question is, after Hurricane Maria, it was difficult for some Puerto Ricans to eat from the small variety of available food. Is it difficult for the astronauts to adapt to their limited menu options?
So we have a pretty good menu, but it repeats itself about every 7 to 14 days. The food is, it's pretty good. It does get a little monotonous, but it's definitely not as good como un pernil, los pasteles, arroz con gandules. So I'm ready to get home and have a great meal.
Hello, I'm Angel Figueroa from Sotero Figueroa, and my question is, what is the minimum number of astronauts required to operate in the ISS, and what is the maximum number of astronauts the ISS can hold?
Pues el mínimo que tenemos aquí son tres astronautas. Pero normalmente tenemos 6, como ahora. A veces tenemos 9. So the least that we will have up here is 3. The normal complement is 6 astronauts like we have right now. Sometimes we will have up to 9. And when we were flying the shuttle, we might have had up to maybe 15 or 16 astronauts. But typically it is 6, and we may increase that up to 7.
Hello, my name is Gabriel, and I'm from Liceo Aguadillano School. My question is, are astronauts allowed to visit any area inside the ISS?
Sí, no hay que tener una visa aquí en la estación. Y ahora mismo, yo soy en el module de Japón, so this is the Japanese module that I'm in right now. And for us to go to the Russian segment, we just float right on over. And they also come over here when we eat together, when they exercise. So we have the whole space station. Y somos un equipo internacional.
How often and how long do you need to exercise in order to maintain muscle and bone health?
Sí, cada día hacemos los ejercicios por como 2 y media horas. Tenemos una bicicleta, tenemos un treadmill, y tenemos otra máquina que se llama A-RED. And the A-RED is a machine that it feels like you are lifting weights. So we do that every day. Para mantenerse los huesos, los músculos, y estamos ahora regresando muy saludable. So we work out every day to maintain our muscles, our bone density, and today astronauts are returning home very, very healthy.
Hi, I am Luis Caraballo Ortiz from the Segundo Ruiz Belvis High School. I want to ask you this. How difficult is it to adapt to microgravity and the sunsets and sunshines each day?
Well, everybody's a little bit different. Most of us do not feel great when we first arrive to the space station, but usually within a week, maybe a month, most of us feel really, really comfortable. You can see, you can move around very easily, and so you become very comfortable. And having the different cycles of day and night does not really affect us unless you're looking out the window. No se siente como tiene ese tiempo. So for me, this time around, it was very comfortable and it felt like coming home.
Hey, my name is Andrea Perez, and I was wondering how difficult is it for the astronauts to go quickly to sleep and if you wake up frequently?
Para mí, no hay problemas, porque al final del día estoy bien cansado y I can sleep. So for me, there's no problem. At the end of the day, most of us are pretty tired and we're ready to go to bed. And for me, I do not wake up all night. And sleeping inside of a bag, it's really, really comfortable. And some of the best sleep of my life has been up here on the International Space Station.
Hi, I'm Fran from Parkville, and I was wondering how often does the ISS encounter potential collision problems like meteorites and space garbage?
Yeah, that's a great question. When we go out on spacewalks, we can see areas where we have been hit by micrometeorites. Also on the windows that we have, we can see that. And for items that we track, if they're big enough, then we can actually go ahead and we can change the orbit of the space station. And I don't know, we probably do that, you know, a couple of times, maybe three times a year to avoid any kind of debris.
We know the space station can recycle purified liquids to make them drinkable. How efficient this process, and how can you describe your experience drinking recycled liquids?
Sí, ya, yo sé que no suena muy bien que estamos tomando que fue orina, pero tenemos un sistema aquí increíble donde podemos reciclar orina, sudor, and the condensation. It probably doesn't sound great, but we do recycle our urine, and we